welcome to Neutral Site Action, and we're just about ready for kickoff. And now we bring you the coin toss, and it's presented by Nissan. Innovation that excites. Florida International tees up the ball as we get ready for the opening kickoff.
Number 25, deep to return.
He's to the 20. Tackle at the 25-yard line. The quarterback brings his troops out onto the field for the first drive of the game. He gets out to about the 25-yard line. And he just gets rid of it. It's third and 10. Ball on their own 25. Over the middle to his tailback. Bounces off a would-be tackler. And that was a really well-played series by the defense.
It did a pretty good job of not letting the offense get much going on that possession.
And down he goes at the 43-yard line.
Not great, but not bad either. As long as your main priorities are not turning the ball over and establishing solid field position, then you're headed in the right direction.
So let's see what the offense can do as they come out onto the field. Quick throw to the tight end. They'll bring him down at the 44.
You know, having a playmaker at tight end makes those linebackers think twice before they make a move. That could be just enough time for the quarterback.
He makes it out to maybe the 43-yard line.
That brings up second and nine.
They go with a screen here, and the halfback's got it. He's taken down around the 39-yard line. Past the tackler, brought down at the 31-yard line.
Just a simple draw play there, but they picked up some big yards.
Steps up in the pocket. Fires quick out to the receiver, and he can't make the grab. So it's second and 10. Ball on the 31-yard line. Here's a screen pass. Gets it to the back. Tackle around the 23-yard line. Complete. He's got room. He makes his way out to about the 9. Nice run, and he's brought down.
That's good to a gain of yards. That brings him second and goal.
He gets rid of this one. The defense got some pressure and forced a bad pass.
I think they've been a little bit more aggressive here with their pass rush, and that time it paid off with an incompletion.
Here's the 11th play of the drive. Hand off to the left. touchdown, Golden Panthers. And he converts the extra point. It was an 11-play, 56-yard drive, and they get it in for 7.
Brad, I thought the offense did a really nice job of mixing up the play calling on that drive. I thought the defense was on its heels most of the drive because of the versatility of the offense.
And it looks like they're ready for the kickoff. Sends it sailing downfield. And it goes into the end zone, down for a touchback.
The Golden Panthers are right where they want to be early in this one, partner.
Well, this is what their coach talked about, getting off to a great start. The defense did their job, and it's nice to see the offense move the ball down the field and also get some points on the board.
And while they are behind, they know they can knot things up in a heartbeat. It's way too early to change your game plan.
There he goes. He's to the 40. Gains his way to the 46-yard line. They go with the option and pick up the first down.
Yeah, and that was a situation where the quarterback knew he could pick up the first down if he kept it himself. That's a good decision.
Easy. Out of bounds at the 49. Gains his way to the 40-yard line. That makes it first and 10.
This quarterback is tough as nails, Brad. He's going to sit in that pocket and give himself a chance. The only problem is, at some point, you've got to have a feel. Almost that sixth sense on when to get out of there and avoid the pressure, or just to throw the ball before you get hit.
Fires to his tight end, nothing doing.
I'm not so sure he made the best decision that time. That was a pretty tight area he was trying to throw that one into.
Third down now, and they need to get it down to the 30. He's picked it off. This time it's the safety.
Not only did he demonstrate his leaping ability, but he also has the hands to be able to pull the ball in. Great job.
From their own 17-yard line, first down. Florida International up 7 points. Catches it, and he's looking for more. Tackle made at about the 47-yard line. And he's taken down at the 42-yard line. Push him out at the 37. Excellent open field tackle. Scrambling. Caught, and he's hit immediately. Hopefully he's going to be okay. We've got a 2nd and 9 here. Ball on the 29-yard line. Setting up blockers, or running backs got it on the screen. Knocked out of bounds at the 23. Man,
carries the ball for a nice game. Florida International is up by a touchdown. He's tackled right around the 16-yard line. He fights forward to about the 13. Through one quarter, Golden Panthers with a touchdown lead. Back to the action now here in the second quarter. The Golden Panthers wide receiver down there on the sideline looks like he's warming up. Good to see that he might be able to get back in this game. Florida International is hoping to make this a two-score game. Kicks up. They head to the sideline with nothing to show for that drive.
Well, slippery down there, but the rain is a bigger problem for the holder. I don't think this kid has any excuse for missing that one.
With one quarter down, I really haven't seen too much separation between these two squads. Might be neck and neck the whole way. They'll spread the field here. Let's see what the defense does with a five wide outlook. Got it, but he's going to lose yards here. And they'll lose a yard there.
Pretty good stand there. They weren't fooled at all by the offensive play call.
And they're going to put six DBs on the field to counter that five receiver look. And down he goes at the 28. Flushed and they got it.
Wow, that is a big hit on the quarterback. That's one of those, as an offensive lineman, when the film study starts to come around, you're going to kind of sink in your chair and just hope they don't call you out, because you're going to get embarrassed on Monday on that one.
They were lucky to prevent a big return there.
Yep, that could have been big if he could have gotten a few more blocks and was able to find the seam.
A missed field goal was the result of the last drive. We'll have to see if they can come through with something this possession.
Yep, it was a rough go-around for this kicker the last time. But this guy won't hang his head. If he has another opportunity to kick one, he'll be ready to go.
He wants it all. Incomplete. Almost picked off.
You know, Brad, the defensive coordinator does a nice job with the coverage call here. Everybody's in position to be able to make the play. The only problem is they didn't intercept the football. That's something that they got to be happy with the coverage, but not happy with the result.
And they get nice yardage on that run. Florida International is up seven. Takes it up the middle for a nice run. And they make the stop at about the 27-yard line. Play here. Got the corner. Inside the 10. And he's tackled at the 7-yard line.
The offensive coordinator has to be elated with the way his offense right now is executing. They're not in a hurry, but they're very, very methodical and very consistent with their approach. It's a third first down that they've picked up on this drive.
That's a great tackle at the 5-yard line. Bring him down at the 2-yard line. Here's the eighth play of the series. wide receiver who made the grab and got the score.
When this guy's got time to throw, he makes the defense pay.
And he adds the extra point. They line up to kick this one away. He makes it out maybe to the 26-yard line.
This defense has everything. They kind of have that blue-collar, workman-like approach, but they also have a blend of tremendous speed to go along with that work ethic. And the better they play, they seem to feed off of it, and it continues throughout the whole ball game.
Not a lot of success for this offense on their last trip out. And they'll get him in the backfield. The defense was all over that draw play.
And he got very good containment on the halfback. He had nowhere to go with the football.
We got a second and 11. Ball on the 25-yard line. And he tackles him hard at the 26. Up a screen, tailback's got it. He's knocked out of bounds at about the 23-yard line. He makes it out to midfield. Golden Panthers are just cruising through this first half, Kirby. Really a comfortable lead here.
Yep, it's still a lot of football left to be played. They got to remember that it's a four-quarter game, and even though that first half went pretty well, things can change in a hurry.
And offense is back on the field after running the ball very well on their last drive.
This offensive line really opened up some big gaps for the running back last time.
The Golden Panthers taking their first time out of the half. It's second down, and they're about 2 yards away from the sticks.
You know what? After a play like that, I wouldn't be the least bit surprised if they went to the air again.
Flushed out, and he's going to get sacked. Is out to the tailback on the screen. He's pushed out of bounds. Right around the 48-yard line. These special teams have done it before, blocking punts. It looks like they're coming after this one. Tackle at the 28-yard line. So now both teams come trotting back out onto the field. And he's hit immediately.
The quarterback and his receiver make a great play here and convert on an early down.
It's second down now, and they're just a few feet away from that first down marker. And they've got all their DBs in there to match up against the five wide set. He's taken down at the 48. Five guys will be out in the pattern as they're in the shotgun. Here's the throw, and I don't think he got anything on that. They didn't have much of a chance on that play.
Boy, this defense has a lot of speed. They're all over him by the time he caught the ball.
They come out in a five-wide set. Got it complete, and he's out of bounds. Good pitch and catch there on second down.
Yep, it was good enough to get him a first down. That's just a nice play.
First down, 10 to go. Ball on the 31. Completes it, and he's hit hard immediately. He scrambled. Brought down around the 27-yard line. Here they come. Just throws this one away.
Even though they didn't sack him, the pressure was still enough to force a bad pass. If you can get in there and disrupt the pocket, then the quarterback is going to have a tougher time getting the ball to his playmakers.
Huge play, and it's going to be first and goal.
That's such a huge letdown for this defense. That kind of conversion is just inexcusable.
Here's the tight end. Drops.
Number nine was the intended receiver.
They're at the seven. It's second down. The Owls lost a player earlier. And Herbie, this is a big blow to this team. Doesn't look like he's going to play any more football today. Quick strike, and he drops it. It's the 11th play of the drive. Quick strike, and it's caught for the touchdown. And did that play ever develop nicely?
Well, it's all about the receiver on this play. He beat his man off the line and then ran a perfect route. All he had to do after that was make the catch.
And it takes some real accuracy on those deep corner routes, so kudos to the quarterback. And he tacks on the extra point. So an 11-play, 72-yard drive, and a touchdown's a result.
Brett, I thought the key to that drive really had a lot to do with the quarterback and the receivers getting in sync, making it very tough for the defense to slow them down.
So our score, 14-7. This one's going to be down in the end zone for a touchback. Momentum swings have been fairly even, and with so little separation, this game can be drastically changed on just one or two plays. Florida International is up a score. Makes it out to about the 43. Golden Panthers call a timeout. That's their second of the half. From their own 43-yard line, first down. I guess he'll throw this one as far as he can and hope for a miracle. He airs it out. Almost picked off. We've played a half. FIU leads 14-7.
Glad to have you with us in the studio for the EA Sports NCAA Football 14 Halftime Show presented by Nissan. Innovation that excites. Reese Davis and David Pollack here completely locked in on that first half.
Both passing games have struggled in the first half, David, and a lot of times you think of defensive backs being finesse type athletes. A lot of physicality shown in that first half.
No doubt about it. And defensive backs, the ones that we like the best, are the ones that can play on an island and play extremely physical, because most offenses are predicated around timing and rhythm. And you see quarterbacks all the time in seven-on-sevens and all summer getting with their wide receivers to try to get that perfect timing. And if you can jam them up at the line of scrimmage, you can mess up that timing. And doing a good job of that, playing close to the line of scrimmage, you know, not letting those receivers get too much wide open spaces and not giving away those easy completions. It's been a clinic so far in the first half.
That's going to do it at halftime. Just about ready to start the second half.
All right, you finish it up, brother. I'm going to get something in the cafeteria. I'm hungry.
Wait, don't leave until you get my order. Brad Kirk, take the second half.
All right, Reese and David, welcome back, everybody. Just about set to start the second half. He's out to the 30. He makes it out to maybe the 33-yard line. quarterback leads the offense back out onto the field as we get set to resume play. Florida International up 7 points. Open man, quick strike, and he can't pull it in. From their own 33-yard line, second down. Tackle around the 34-yard line. And out left to the running back. Tackle made at about the 37-yard line. They look like they've got the block on, and this offensive line's got to give him some time. Booming kick. He makes it out to maybe the 29-yard line. This deficit can be easily overcome, sure. But they have to be thinking if they don't get something going on this series, the burden is going to be felt by their defense. Looking for his man, incomplete. From their own 29-yard line, it's second down. Pitch and catch for the first down, and he's taken down at the 47. That makes it first and 10. He's under pressure. He's tackled at the 38. Over the middle, intercepted. He came up with a fantastic interception there.
Well, you know the quarterback is kicking himself for that one. He just made the wrong read.
First down, 10 yards to go. Ball on their own 34. Florida International is up by a touchdown. He fights forward to about the 36. And they get him in the backfield for a loss. It to the halfback on the screen, and they push him out at the 46-yard line. He gets out to about the 48-yard line. Receiver. And down he goes around the 41-yard line. And he's hit before he can go anywhere. There's a player down. I'm not sure what happened. And this play is number 8 on the drive. Incomplete. Nice job getting a hand on that one.
Yeah, really good heads-up play there to get a hand on the football by the defense.
Second down and 10 to go. Ball on the 30. Florida International is up 7. Gives it up the gut. Loose football. Scoops it up. So the offense turns over the pigskin.
The ball carrier here was just careless in handling the ball. And a great awareness by the defense to jump on it.
We'll have to see now how the offense responds this time after throwing a pick on their last drive.
This quarterback can make good passes. He just needs to focus on not forcing the ball to his receivers.
Quick throw. And they make the stop at the 32. He's out of bounds at the 38-yard line. Tackled at the 46. Complete, brought down, nothing doing. About the 49. Out of bounds, right around the 46-yard line. So it's fourth down, and the offense is still on the field. The Golden Panthers lost one of their key guys earlier to that injury, and unfortunately, I don't think he's going to play any more football today. Up the middle for a nice game. Got the corner. He gets hit out of bounds. Right around the 28-yard line. Bring him down at the 28. Here's the give. He's brought down in the open field. Looks like someone got a head start on the line.
Offense.
They'll give this one another try after the flag.
And on third down, too. That's when you don't want those kind of things to happen.
Third down now, and they need to get it to the 18. So at the end of three, FIU leads 14-7. into the fourth quarter now, and we're back to the action. Tackled after a decent pickup. Around 4 yards there on the quarterback keeper. Under pressure. And that one's incomplete. And once again, the coaches decided to go for it on fourth down. So an empty backfield with five wide receivers. Fires out to his receiver. He's taken down at the 9. Things aren't tied, but they might as well be. It's this drive that could really dictate the tone for the last quarter. Florida International is up a score. And he almost has the INT.
Well, you want to do everything you can to keep the ball out of the hands of these receivers. So that was a really good effort.
From their own 9-yard line, second down. Makes the grab and steps out right away.
He is such a reliable target. You throw it anywhere near him, and this guy's going to get his hands on it and make a catch.
A little toss across the middle, and he's leveled at the 33-yard line. He's got an opening. He's pushed out of bounds at the 39. Quick pass. He's into the open field. Brought down at the 45. They pick up a good 6 yards there.
The defense here let the halfback roam free for a second, and they were able to connect for a short gain on the play.
Him open field. He's knocked out of bounds around the 48-yard line. Caught, and he's hit immediately. Here's the 8th play of the series. Florida International up 7 points. Caught, open field, and he shoved out of bounds at the 35.
Brad, I just think this quarterback's got to do a much better job of being able to read that defense and make quicker decisions. And especially when the defense starts to get pressure, you've got to either get rid of that football or check it down or take off and run with it.
He steps out at about the 33-yard line. Tackle right there. And it's the offense that takes the field on fourth down. Complete, but out of bounds. Going to lose some ground. Both teams realize that when the ball is snapped, we're one play away from a very different ball game.
Mike 13, Mike 13.
has it on the corner. He's at midfield. And they bring him down at the 37. A little more than 2 minutes to go in the fourth quarter. He's got the corner. He gets another carry. Good tackle there in space.
That's a deal. That'll make it second and inches.
Another carry, and he's brought down for a loss. It's third down, and they're about the length of the football away from the first down marker. He fights forward to about the 26. Deep pass to the end zone. Second down, 10 to go. Ball on the 26-yard line. Slings it, and he's hit immediately.
This quarterback is tough as nails. Brad, he's going to sit in that pocket and give himself a chance. The only problem is, at some point, you've got to have a feel, almost that sixth sense on when to get out of there and avoid the pressure, or just to throw the ball before you get hit.
Well, you can talk about offense all you want, and they were good today, but the defense was better. They come up with a play of the day, and that'll lead to the victory. You know this is a real crucial time in the game. It could still go either way. Just over a minute left. After positive yardage, the Owls will use their first time out of the half. Second and six. Ball on their own 30. He makes it out to maybe the 33-yard line. He picked up around 3 yards on the draw play. The Owls are going to call their second timeout. And he carries the ball for a nice game. That's around 5 yards gained there on the play for the tailback.
Good decision making that time on the option. He read the defense perfectly and was able to make a good pitch.
The offense lining up in a victory formation, and he takes a knee. From their own 36-yard line, second down. We should just see the quarterback take a knee right here, winding down the rest of this clock. And he'll just take a knee here to kill the clock. Golden Panthers get the victory, 14-7. So what are your final thoughts on this one, Kirk?
Florida International came out here today and played with the heart and intensity that you love to see in a rivalry game. They should be very proud of their victory because wins don't come easy between these two teams.
Does it for this edition of NCAA Football 14. For Kirk Herbstreit, I'm Brad Nessler saying so long.